Today we are going to save almost 800 euros on a plotter for the exterior of our boat or on one of those super cool displays that the big racing sailboats have at the base of the mast so the whole crew knows what's happening. Because today we are going to see how to convert a motorcycle navigator costing less than 80 euros into a 7-inch plotter, an MFD suitable for outdoor use that will have little or nothing to envy from the 800 euro equipment of the major brands. I won't mention any.
800 euros is a lot of money.
It's a lot of savings. Greetings, fellow sailors, and welcome to another exciting episode of The Low-Cost Sailor. In today's episode, we delve into the pages of the book of The Low-Cost Sailor, where we will explore how, with equipment costing under 80 euros from AliExpress, originally designed for installation on the exterior of motorcycles, we can construct a 7-inch plotter suitable for outdoor use, boasting impressive brightness, GPS capabilities, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and Android 13. It will have nothing to envy from the latest plotters of the major brands, which are fundamentally the same. Bright screens with Android and some communication protocols, although in the case of major brands, it's restricted, so you can only install the things they allow.
Do you watch AliExpress at night instead of Netflix and stuff?
I read AliExpress even in the bathroom instead of the shampoo instructions like before.
In the bathroom you read AliExpress?
I read AliExpress.
I believe it.
Because it's true. Let's see which model is suitable for use on our boat. We will review its features and test it in all types of conditions. We will additionally observe how, by installing certain Android applications, it can effectively perform the functions of a highly advanced plotter and serve as a multifunction display, an MFD, to present the boat's data in a clear and visible manner to the entire crew. And all this for less than 80 euros. Specifically, it cost me 76.69 on AliExpress.
70 bucks versus 600, 700.
800?
800.
The Action 7, which I checked for comparison, 800 bucks. Throughout the episodes of this channel, we have observed how crucial information becomes when we are navigating and how, in conditions of reduced visibility, having well-updated charts on an electronic device such as a plotter, which positions us in real time on them and alerts us to depths, concealed rocks, the coastline, and even other vessels, has become incredibly valuable, making navigation significantly easier and more accessible for everyone. Although not particularly affordable, since the displays and navigation plotters from prominent brands continue to have quite high prices, and mind you, I'm not suggesting they aren't justified, because there are some truly excellent devices available, but as of today, they remain out of reach for many individuals. If you were to ask me which is the most suitable nautical plotter for my boat, my response is going to be whatever you can afford. With this idea, throughout our episodes, we have seen how a mobile phone or a tablet with Android can be a great substitute, offering the same functions and even more at a much more affordable price. We've seen affordable, rugged tablets made for these tasks. The highlight was showing how to achieve the same function with a car radio for only 60 euros. Certainly, the one I possessed back there for that particular price became absolutely unbeatable. I strongly encourage you to recall our episode number 80. It simply wasn't waterproof, so it only functioned as a substitute for the plotter inside the boat or in well-protected areas. But here it serves me incredibly well. However, I had a lingering thought. What if there was an option like this? What if it could be used outside and withstand the rain? The key seemed to be in the world of motorcycles, because motorcycle navigators are designed to be outdoors, endure vibrations, direct sunlight, and even downpours. However, the significant question remains, would there be an affordable yet sufficiently powerful option to become the ultimate outdoor plotter for our boat? This is precisely what we are going to explore today.
For motorcycles, not for jet skis.
For motorcycles. This would work for a jet ski. If any followers are on a jet ski, you can put this on a jet ski too. I had been searching for a year and a half among motorcycle navigators for something that would serve my purposes and could be used as a plotter for outdoor use. It might seem unbelievable because when we published episode 80, some of you were already suggesting motorcycle navigators to me. There are numerous waterproof motorcycle navigators available on AliExpress, and they were already accessible at that time, but they were all displays that supported Android Auto or CarPlay, requiring a connected mobile phone to operate. Keep in mind, that's excellent for a car or motorcycle navigator. In fact, that's what's integrated into my wife's Dacia, and I don't miss anything at all in a car. As a multimedia or navigation system with Android Auto, it works for me, but those devices are designed to use Google Maps on the road, and that's not as useful when you're not on roads. They are very affordable devices, some starting from 35 euros, but they are closed systems, not allowing you to install or change anything on them. However, perseverance paid off, and a few weeks ago, I finally found it. FKMTC21. Do not be concerned, we shall provide the hyperlinks in the detailed description of the video. A 7-inch touchscreen display with 800 nits of brightness, IP-rated water resistance, designed to operate between negative 20 and 70 degrees Celsius, 4 processing cores, 2 gigabytes of RAM, and 32 gigabytes of storage capacity. Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, GPS, well, it has everything. And the fundamental difference for our purpose is that inside there is a complete Android 13 with access to the Google Play Store, which opens the door for us to install any application as if it were a tablet or a mobile phone, but prepared for outdoor use. The initial task I aimed to accomplish was to verify its functionality and understand its usage on a motorcycle without altering any components. Indeed, what more effective method to evaluate this equipment on a motorcycle than by consulting a renowned YouTuber who is an expert in motorcycles, someone I'm confident you are all familiar with.
What are you saying? That you called? Don't tell me you called. To Majors. To Majors on a motorcycle.
It's me.
Your Majors? Your Majors? But then, now everything makes sense.
No, I'm the famous YouTuber. How could I be Majors? I'm the famous YouTuber who knows about motorcycles.
But how are you going to be a famous YouTuber? Only 4 people know you.
But for those watching us, I'm famous because it's the 4 people who know me who are watching us. Jeez. And mind you, I've had motorcycles since I was a teenager. I've taken them apart, fixed them, broken them, fallen, and gotten back up 1,000 times. Well, I know a little about motorcycles. Well, not too much. Anyway, I installed it on my bike and took it for a spin to test it out. And honestly, these screens are really good. Everything looks huge, the screen has good brightness, and it's touch sensitive even with gloves, which provides a lot of safety if you can find a place where it fits on the bike, of course. Just having the navigation visible while you ride and connected via Bluetooth to the helmet's audio is already a plus, especially if you use it with Android Auto, because it allows you to respond to messages by voice, take calls without getting distracted. The touch feature works great even with gloves, and its minimalist interface provides everything you need on a motorcycle. And regarding the full Android topic, well, on a motorcycle, it doesn't seem like a significant difference to me, because in the end, you always have your phone in your pocket, and with Android Auto, you have just what you need. However, on a boat, possessing the complete Android system is truly the significant distinction, and that is the crucial aspect. For a boat, it would not have been appropriate if it lacked the full Android functionality. When the equipment finally arrives, the box contains an assortment of accessories. Initially, we have the screen itself, from which a cable extends with 2 connectors, one for the included external GPS antenna, and another waterproof connector that connects to a compact box where the power converter is situated. The device essentially functions at 5 volts, but due to the inclusion of the converter, we are able to power it from 12 volts to 24 volts, or any intermediate voltage in between. To power it, we have 3. The black goes to the negative of the battery, the yellow goes to the positive of the battery, and the red goes to the ignition so that the device turns on only when you have the ignition on, for example on a motorcycle, and turns off when you remove it. From my tests, the first thing I've verified is that if you plug it in the wrong way, it doesn't burn out because I've made that mistake at some point, and I also suspect that the yellow doesn't go anywhere because if you only plug in the red, it still works perfectly. Well, if you want a simple installation, just connect the red and yellow to the positive and the black to the negative of the battery. Connect it and that's it. We start the equipment and it begins to work. If you want to use its internal GPS, you'll need to place the antenna in a spot where there's nothing metallic above it that could block the satellite signal. On a fiberglass boat, it practically works anywhere, whether inside or outside. On a metal boat, it must be on the exterior, or in a skylight, or someplace where there is no metal above.
Because if you don't make Faraday cages...
Of course.
You were surprised, weren't you?
What you have learned with this channel... The energy consumption is quite low, between 0.25 and 0.35 amperes, operating at 12 volts, depending mainly on the brightness level you set. In the box, we will also find a clamp mount with a ball joint that allows us to hold and orient it as we like. It connects the rear ball of the device with another base designed for the motorcycle handlebar, which is easily adaptable to any boat handle or any railing. Moreover, the device comes with a waterproof protective cover that conceals a USB Type-C port for connecting various accessories and a microSD card slot to expand storage capacity. The accessories can be useful during installation, like a keyboard, mouse, etc. However, if the cover is on, it loses its IP rating, so you won't be able to leave anything connected there for outdoor use. And above all else, do not forget to securely put it back after disconnecting whatever you want from the USB Type-C port so that water does not seep in. And that is it. We can utilize the pre-installed applications, such as Google Maps, a GPS testing tool, or the music and video players, as all of these come pre-installed. Well, it even comes with YouTube pre-installed. You just connect it to the internet and you can watch our videos. However, the device doesn't have a speaker, so if you want to listen to something, you'll need to pair it via Bluetooth with headphones or an external speaker. Well, by installing the appropriate applications, we can turn it into a very useful component for the framework. It can function as a state-of-the-art nautical plotter. You just need to install your favorite navigation apps, Navionics, which is now called Garmin Boating, OpenCPN, OrcaPilot, which I like a lot lately, or whichever one you prefer. You can add extra applications for anything you can think of. We already covered this part in the car radio episode, and it can be applied in exactly the same way. Here I encourage you to review the episode. I think the link to the episode will appear around here. You can install whatever you want, as it's a full Android, that's the advantage. And if the installation becomes complicated, you can buy it with the OpenCPN application installed, along with free and customized charts to make it work. All you need to do is, just like with these radios, visit our online store. So if you feel capable of doing it yourself, great, and if not, you can request it done for you. The true value of these devices is especially evident once we connect them to the boat's Wi-Fi. If you have followed our episodes, you will know that from that moment on, we can have all the information from our instruments transmitted via NMEA Wi-Fi and display it on these screens to see it like never before. Here, applications like Nav Monitor or NMEA Dashboard come into play. Free applications that turn this screen into a super complete MFD, displaying any boat data you have from an NMEA source via Wi-Fi. In my case, the data is provided by the onboard Raspberry Pi, to which all the electronics of my boat are connected. Depending on the specific location where you place it, you can utilize it for various purposes. If you attach it with a clip to the binnacle, it functions as an ideal low-cost external plotter. By removing the four screws from the mount and the sunshade, it transforms into a perfect frame to embed it somewhere on the boat, for instance, and it would then serve as a permanent plotter there. For example, I printed a small 3D adapter to attach it with ties to the mast of the boat and get one of those regatta MFDs that display all the navigation data to the entire crew, like the expensive boats that have a big display with large numbers under the mast, but for a tenth of the usual price, so this is also useful for people in regattas. Once we have everything configured, it's time to test it on board as a plotter. Honestly, I was surprised at how smoothly the applications run. It has more than enough power, and the performance is very similar to the radio we saw in episode 80. The resolution of 1024x600 pixels falls a bit short in some applications, but it's not so much a problem of resolution as it is the size of the fonts, icons, and default windows in certain applications. We even have the option to split the screen and display two applications at once, which is great. You can have two data points from Navionics and another for navigation. The combination with the launcher that comes installed is very simple, perhaps not as attractive as the Agama launcher, the one we install on the radios, but honestly, it can be more than sufficient depending on how you use it. The touchscreen responds very well, it's capacitive, but nowadays almost all screens are. It allows multi-touch gestures with several fingers at once and even works with gloves. It does not have any problems with water resistance. However, as is the case with all capacitive screens, droplets can cause it to behave somewhat erratically. If rain or splashes happen, you might need to dry it off to use it with complete precision. But, you know, that's the same with all of them. In any case, you don't have to be afraid of water, rain, waves, or even the worst storms. It won't ruin it. As for the brightness, the manufacturer promises 800 nits, and I can tell you it has them when compared to other devices we've used on the channel, like the Ukitel RT7 or the Orca Display 2, which has 1000 nits. It's at the same level. It looks spectacular outdoors, which is what really matters. However, for quick brightness control from the menu, if you want to get the full splendor, you have to go to Settings, Display, Brightness, and there you can set it to 100%, and that's where you'll see the 800 nits shining in all their glory. And how about a multifunction navigation display for boats? Compared to my Garmin multifunction display that costs 400 euros, honestly, it doesn't have much to envy. Perhaps I just miss having a physical button to handle it better in the rain. However, to see large numbers during regattas placed on the mast, it works wonderfully. At any distance, with direct sunlight or rough seas, it looks great. One thing I don't like is the external GPS antenna, but if you're going to use it with NMEA data via Wi-Fi, you might not even need to use the GPS antenna because it will use the GPS data coming through the boat's Wi-Fi and you wouldn't even need to plug it in. As for the waterproof connector, it wouldn't have been my choice for a removable system, but it performs its function perfectly. Just make sure that if you remove it when you're not on board, you should protect the cable you leave on board to prevent water from getting in. Ultimately, for 80 euros, it is genuinely quite remarkable. And now comes the most thrilling part, which is testing it while sailing. We all understand that it is not absolutely necessary to test it while sailing, but hey, what better reason to go out sailing for a bit than needing to capture these images for the video?
It's work, it's work.
Honey, it's work. Well, it took me a while, but I must say that this gadget is amazing for its price. I hope other manufacturers of these motorcycle devices are encouraged to include a full Android so we have more options. I'm telling you, the weak spot is this connection. I'm not too convinced by it. I would have preferred something quick, an integrated connector here that connects if you disconnect, well.
But if you're not going to put it on and take it off, if you're going to leave it in one place.
If you're going to leave it fixed, that's perfect. You can integrate it, as I said, put it there, or even if you remove this entire edge in the logbook, you can make the cut and have it fully integrated for 80 bucks. Well, less than 80 bucks, I deserve this.
And the best part, everything is set up in the online store. Crazy.
You have the video to set it up, you can review the other one, but if you don't dare, if you want it already done, you can ask us, we'll do it and everyone will be happy. So cheer up, all my friends who race, I think they will end up putting it there on the mast because those people, the plotters, are not very fond of them. And naturally, for sailors who are mindful of their budgets, this is indeed an excellent solution. It has truly convinced me. It has genuinely convinced me. Thank you very much for your attention, sailors. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. If you did, please give us a like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell to receive notifications. You can find all the links in the description, the video, and the post on our website, www.thelowcostsailor.com. You can also see this device in our online store. I can't say goodbye without thanking the people who are helping to keep this channel running, our Patreons who will appear here on the screen, our main sponsor this year, Smart Sails, and all of you who watch, support, donate, participate, comment, or help push this forward. Thank you very much, and we'll see you in a couple of weeks in a new episode of The Low Cost Sailor.
There's a gentleman here representing the evil plotters manufacturers, and he wants to talk with you. What should I tell him?
Is he armed?
I'm uncertain if he possesses one. Perhaps he indeed has bodyguards. Let's make a run for it. Come on, let's go, go, go.